Friends, welcome back to our channel, Nurses Nook and Corner. Let's make it easy on the topic push tool. Today in this video, we are going to learn about push tool. Push tool is nothing but pressure ulcer scale for healing. What's that? Pressure ulcer scale for healing is a simple tool to know the healing status of pressure injury, whereas Braden scale, which we have seen in the previous video, helps us to assess only the risk of pressure injury in the patient. But push scale helps us to know the healing status and the prognosis of the patient. To make the patient happy and feel safe, we have to assess the skin for healing appropriately with the tool PUSH, push pressure ulcer scale for healing. It's time to see regarding the parameters of push scale. There are three parameters that are considered most indicative of healing. The first one is length into width, second is exudate amount, third is tissue type. Now let's see one by one. Let's see the scoring pattern of the parameters. So the three parameters, length into width, exudate amount and tissue type, are given in this format. For length into width, you can give a score up to 10. For exudate amount, you can give a score up to 3. And for tissue type, you can give a score up to 4. So let's see in detail now. The first parameter is length into width. You have to measure the greatest length in the manner from head to toe and the greatest width, that is from side to side, using a centimeter ruler. And multiply these two measurements, that is length into width, to obtain the estimate of surface area in square centimeters. Since length is also in centimeter and width is also centimeter, while multiplying both you will get a centimeter square. And the warning is that you should not guess. You should not guess the centimeters. You should always use a ruler and also the same method each time when the ulcer is measured. Let's see an example now. So if you see the wound and you want to measure the length into width, you have to take the greatest length in the manner of head to toe. So if you check, the length is 6 cm. And if you check for greatest from side to side, the width is about 5 cm. Therefore, if you calculate length into width, then it is 30 cm². So you should not take the 30 as the score. Now we have to take the chart and compare with it the length into width. If you compare with the chart, 0 to 10 is the scoring and 0 to about 24 is the measurement of length into width. In example, it is given that length into width is 30 cm². So it is about 24 and the scoring will be 10 here. So you have to give a score of 10 if the patient had more than 24 cm². The second parameter is exudate amount. Estimate the amount of exudate present after removal of dressing and before applying any topical agent to the ulcer. So you have to estimate as none, light, moderate or heavy. So in the example, if you see here, the exudate amount is none, light, moderate or heavy. It's not too heavy since there is granulation tissue surrounding the area and not too light. So here you can mark it as moderate. Comparing with the chart, now you have to give a score of 2 as moderate and in the subscore area you have to write it as 2. The third parameter is tissue type. This refers to the type of tissue that are present in the wound. Score 4 for necrotic tissue present, 3 for slough present, 2 clean and contains granulation tissue, 1 re-epithelizing tissue, and 0 is when the wound is closed. So this is the chart for tissue type. Pictorial representation of tissue type. 0, closed, if wound completely covered with epithelium, new skin. Epithelial tissue, score 1. For superficial ulcers, new pink or shiny tissue growing from edges. Score 2, granulation tissue, pink or beefy red tissue with a shiny moist granular appearance. 3, slough, yellow or white tissue that adheres to ulcers in strings or thick clumps. Score 4, necrotic tissue, black, brown or tan tissue that adheres firmly to wound bed or under edges. It is also known as scar. So the example of tissue type, in the wound there is a yellow tissue that adheres to ulcer, so you have to give a score of 3, that is slough. Now in the tissue type, you have to write the subscore as 3. Now we have to calculate the total score calculation. So length into width is given a score of 10, exudate amount is given a score of 2 and tissue type is given a score of 3. Therefore the total score is 15. Once you have found out the score of pressure ulcer, the next step is the healing graph, where you have to mark the score daily in the graph sheet to find out the prognosis of the pressure ulcer. So here, if the score is 15, you have to mark in the score sheet, that is in the graph sheet, as 15, and daily you have to mark the graph and come. Once if it goes downwards, then the healing process is occurring, but if the score increases, then there is the worsening of pressure ulcer. Therefore the healing is slowing down of score, and if there is worsening, the score will be increasing. How to heal fast? So follow these 5 steps to heal your pressure ulcer quickly. Surface, make sure your patients have the right support. Skin inspection, early inspection means early detection. Show patients and carers what to look for, especially the pressure points. Keep your patients moving, that is ambulate frequently or change the position in order to avoid pressure ulcer. Incontinence or moisture, your patients need to be clean and dry. Nutrition and hydration, help patients have the right diet and plenty of fluids. So follow these 5 steps to heal the patient. So Worldwide Pressure Injury Day is observed on 19th November 2020. If you see, the cost of healing 10 pressure injuries is equivalent to cost of 5 knee replacement, cost of 6 hip replacement, cost of 9 pacemakers and cost of 5 bypass operations. So stop pressure ulcers by preventing them. Thank you friends. Keep watching and supporting. If you didn't subscribe the channel, don't forget to subscribe the channel. Follow us in Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, as well as in YouTube. If you like the video, press the like icon and share it to your friends. Thank you.